everyone. Today I'm going to be doing an oil change, an oil filter change for my Kawasaki Vulcan 800. It's a 2003. And just a little video tutorial to walk you through all the steps involved.
The first step is to have all your tools ready. So I'm going to start here. We see what I've got. I have my oil and oil filter and rags. My oil filter wrench, the wrench for the oil drain plug, and my oil drain pan. You're going to want to warm up the bike. Then you're going to put your bike on the center or side stand. So I've got it on the side there, and I'm going to position the oil drain pan as close to the bolt, underneath the bolt, and as close to the oil filter as possible. That's where the bigger drain pans come in handy, because as we're draining the oil, we're going to loosen the filter as well, and we're going to get some oil coming out of there. Once your oil pan is in place, we're going to get in with the wrench. I believe it's usually 17 millimeter. On my bike it certainly is. And we're going to unscrew carefully the oil drain plug. Try not to let the bolt fall out into the oil. If it does, you just grab it quickly. The oil's going to be pretty warm, so you want to get it out quickly and not burn your hands. As the used or dirty oil is draining, we're going to loosen off the oil filter using the oil filter wrench. You want to carefully unscrew the oil filter. You don't want to move any of the residue that it's captured during its lifespan. And drain any oil left over in it into your oil pan. As my bike is not on a center stand, it seems to have pretty well stopped draining, but I'm going to stand on the bike and just level it to get any excess oil out. Once your dirty oil is all drained out, you're going to want to clean the drain bolt with a clean rag. Make sure there's no grime on there. And once you get it on a couple threads, you can pull away the oil drain pan. So I usually just tighten it a bit by hand. And then remove the dirty oil pan. Now I'm going to get the wrench and tighten it on there. Now, again, you don't want to tighten it too much. If you have a torque wrench, you can go by your factory settings. And just remember that NM does not equal foot-pounds. Otherwise, tighten it as much as it will go, and then give it about a quarter of a turn more. Just a bit more. Now I'm going to prep the new oil filter. I'm going to put a little bit of oil inside of it so that the area gets wet inside. Swoosh it around a little bit. You want to get all the filter material down there wet with oil. Now, and this is very important, we're going to prep the rubber seal with a dab of oil on your finger. So you want to just get the whole seal wet. So I'm going to get some oil on my finger and just run it around the rubber seal. And you want to make sure that the entire seal is wet. You don't need very much. Now we're going to clear the filter area on the engine of grime.
using a clean rag. And we're going to prep that area the same way, with a dab of oil, just to get, so we get a good clean contact in there. Now I'm going to carefully screw on the new filter. You really don't need to force this, it should go quite easily. And you tighten it as much as you can by hand. We're not going to use a tool at all at this phase. Now it goes on quite easily there. And once you get to that point where it doesn't take much effort to turn, we're only going to turn it about 3/4 of a turn more. You really don't want to over-tighten an oil filter, and you shouldn't need more really than a clean hand to tighten it. You don't want to use a tool unless your tool is attached to a torque wrench and you are tightening it to factory specs. So I'm going to go about 3/4 of a turn further. And that's all we really need. At this point, the bike is ready to take on its new oil. To fill the oil, there should be a screw on my bike. It's on the left-hand side, and it's clearly marked oil. I've already unscrewed it here and placed it on a rag there. And you should check your factory manual if your bike doesn't say on the side the capacity of oil that the engine takes. On mine, I don't know if you can see it too well, but there's a little sticker there, and it reads, oil capacity, filter not removed, 2.7 liters. With the filter removed, 2.9 liters. So I have 3 liters of oil here. And what I'm going to do is pour about, it calls 2.9, I'm going to pour about 2.5 liters in, and then check the level by reading the side, the oil level side. If you have a filter, if you have a funnel, of course that's preferable, but I don't seem to have one handy here, but it's pretty easy to pour with the wide oil fill there, so I'm just going to get some going. So I've put in about 2.5 liters of oil right now. It's calling for 2.9 liters. But most bikes have a oil level reader. On mine, you can see it right here. And what you're going to want to do is see at what level that is. It has a high and a low level, and you want to see roughly where it's at. And you cannot do this when it's on the side stand. It has to be standing vertical. So this is where it comes in really handy, having someone else to stand there and check the oil level for you or straighten the bike. But in my case, you, the camera, and the viewer are going to be my eyes. So I'm going to straighten the bike. And hopefully you can see the oil level there. So you can see there my oil level was a little low. What I like to do is keep it roughly halfway between the high and the low level on your reader there on the side. After that, you're going to want to make sure all your nuts and bolts are tight again and your oil filter is nice and tight. And that's about it. You're done. You've saved a little bit of coin. Remember, disposing of oil, most places that sell the oil will take it back again. I'll put a list up on the website of places in the area in Toronto and Ontario here that do take back dirty oil. It's handy having one of these oil drain pans. It has a funnel in it, so you can pour it back into the bottles, the empty oil bottles that you use to fill up the bike. That's about it. You're going to take it for a ride, warm it up, bring it back, and you want to check the bolts again and check the oil level again. And besides that, keep the rubber on the road.